Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. Okay, it's time to cook. It's time to make seared scallops with Chef Chris Gless from the Rusty Nail. Welcome back, senor.
Thank you, sir.
Good to have you.
Good to be here.
Shake the chef's hands. We're going to make some scallops today. Rusty Nail, that's on what, Route 43, is it, on the way to Kent, right?
Yes.
Between Streetsboro and Kent.
Between Streetsboro and Kent.
I went cruising by there the other day. The parking lot was loaded. It was around 6 o'clock, so things are happening over there.
Excellent, yes.
You must have a cocktail hour.
Yes. Yeah, yes. We have a good... good regular crowd that comes in every day.
I could tell. I was on the way to a baseball game. My car kept wanting to go in there. So what are we cooking here today?
Today we are cooking pan-seared sea scallops, which we serve over a caramelized shallot and cherry tomato salad.
So how do you guys make these when it has a nice crispy look on the outside and they're not overcooked? It's sort of hard to do for some folks.
Basically, you want to start out with a nice hot pan.
Yeah. You put oil in the pan?
Yes, put oil in the pan. You... I'm going to get a good seasoning on them. I use kosher salt and fresh ground black pepper. And actually start these here.
Okay. Waiting for that pan to get a little hot there, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And then you don't move them around much after you start them, huh?
No, that's another thing. Once you get them in the pan, you want to let them cook for at least a couple minutes, get nice and brown.
Uh-huh.
And basically, just like on the grill, you don't want to pick them up before they before they're ready. If they're sticking, they're not ready.
From what I'm seeing here, too, a lot of people under-season things. Like, you got a good amount of salt on there, a good amount of pepper.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Pretty stuff, too. These scallops, they're not giving those away, either. They're about $16 a pound, I think, when you go to the store.
Yeah, right around there.
Okay. What other kind of things do you have on the menu at the Rusty Nail?
We have a good amount of steaks. Steakhouse, a lot of fresh seafood.
So it's a steakhouse then?
Yes, yes.
Excellent.
Yes. It's been around since 1967,
mm-hmm.
So it's always been a steakhouse. I've always been known for that, so yeah.
Did it change locations in the old days? Was it a place closer to the road? Because it's a bigger building now, I think, isn't it?
Yes, it used to be closer to Route 43.
Yeah.
They actually built a banquet hall first, which we have a 200-person banquet hall, and then ended up moving
the
restaurant.
Did you have to cook for that too?
Yes.
So how hard is that to cook for 200 people at once?
Get used to it.
Yeah, I guess you do.
Get it down to a science. So
what else is going on here with this?
This is what I call a salad here. It is caramelized.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's caramelized shallots, roasted cherry tomatoes, mm-hmm. and it's all cooked in a pan with some fresh herbs, basil, oregano, fresh garlic.
So that's a quick saute. So that's what you're going to do in here?
Yes.
Well, let's do it. Look at these raw vegetables, and I'm starting to feel too healthy. Cook them. Do something with these things.
Get some oil in there. And
oh, yeah, that's that one that's got the low burner on. There you go.
Oh, yeah.
So how do those come in? How long do you cook on each side?
Usually do on this size, usually about two and a half minutes on mm-hmm. the first side. Flip them over, cook them for about another minute, and then they're good. You don't need to cook them all the way through.
Yeah. Can you tell by touching them when they're done?
Yeah.
That's how you do it?
Yeah.
Not much bounce probably, huh?
Not a whole lot. You want a little bit there, but...
Oh, look how beautiful those are.
You can touch it kind of like you can a steak.
Yeah.
And that's something, years ago someone told me a scallop was like the filet mignon of the sea.
Oh.
I always tell people that are scared of scallops. So.
Yeah, it is. It's terrific too, isn't it? It's a rich seafood too, so.
It is.
Like four would be a pretty big helping, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
So that's how you guys roll over there at the Rusty Nail, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, we like to keep you full. Don't want you to leave hungry.
So. Okay, I want to tell these guys at home, too, also, this is Rusty Nail is the real deal of the week, and that means starting at 9 a.m. tomorrow morning, you can purchase a $50 gift certificate for half price. So it's going to cost you $25, get $50 worth of stuff at the Rusty Nail, and you go to our website, that's fox8.com, and I want to remind you that the real deal of the week doesn't include liquor. So it just includes the food charges on that. So that way when you go, you know, you can't, you know, you're going to buy a martini or a bottle of wine, you're paying for that, but you get all the food, like, almost half price then.
Yeah, absolutely.
How soon do you throw the rest of this stuff in there?
I actually cook the shallots for probably about 15 minutes. Uh-huh. I do have some made up here. Just bring out a little bit of the sweetness in them, soften them up.
Okay. So. And this is what you're going to plate it on here?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you got about 30 seconds here.
Okay.
if you want to plate those up, show us what it looks like.
Yeah.
And don't forget, Rusty Nail is a steakhouse. You've got seafood. What other seafood do you have on the menu?
We have fresh salmon on the menu. We have walleye, a baked walleye. Nice healthy dish there.
What do you fry there? Because I'm a fried fish guy.
Haddock. Every Friday night since they opened the doors in 67, we've done a beer-battered haddock.
So that's like a fish and chips kind of thing?
Yeah.
Love that.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go, folks. Let's put this together now, and we'll let you return. It's some spring pampering time. That's right, soap that looks good enough to eat. Not as good as this to eat. I think the soap is beautiful, but you can't eat it. Hey, it's calorie-free treats when we return. Check it out. I like this too, Chef.
Thank you.